Hello, Meg here from PMTVUK, and we are going to talk everything acoustic guitar pickups. One of the biggest factors in being a gigging acoustic guitarist is your acoustic guitar pickup and how it sounds on stage. If any of you watching have seen my video on the history of acoustic guitars, or any of my acoustic videos to be fair, you would have seen me talk about the evolution of acoustic guitar pickups, or you would have just heard some of the guitars plugged in. Well, in this video, I thought it'd be interesting to find out some of the different qualities about each acoustic guitar pickup, why you would go for which one, and what each of them do. Before I do dive into that though, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any other videos from Dagan or myself. So acoustic guitar pickups, where did it begin? Well, we need to go back to the early 20th century where two Gibson employees, Lloyd Law and Harry Diamond, began working on a brand new pickup for acoustic guitars. With the bands of the time growing in size, with big band, jazz and music genres like this in the forefront, you can imagine how miking up an acoustic guitar was becoming more and more necessary. When you are surrounded by instruments as loud as a piano or a trumpet, a saxophone, anything like this, you can just imagine how easy it is for an acoustic guitar to get lost in this mix. Therefore, it became more and more necessary for acoustic guitarists to find a way to amplify their sound. Back in the early days, the only option you would have had would be to mic up your acoustic guitar. Whilst this is still a viable option, and you can do this if you wish, I'm sure if you've tried it before, it can be a little limiting. The most obvious reason for that is you have to stay stationary in one place to get the right sound coming through, or to get a balanced sound of your acoustic. If you're anything like myself, when I'm playing guitar, I tend to move around, and when you're on stage, you want to enjoy that time up there and really get into your playing. Sometimes that means taking a lunge or two with your guitar, moving towards your bass player, or whatever it is that gets you engaged with the crowd. So standing stationary in front of a microphone is not the best for that. It's also well known that microphones do tend to have feedback issues, and if you've got a particularly bassy or loud acoustic guitar, you're more than likely going to run into some of these issues. So to eliminate that, what do you do? Well, you need to have an acoustic guitar pickup so you can plug your guitar in. It depends how you are doing it at a gig. Most commonly you would be DIing your acoustic guitar, going into a desk and then out to speakers. But in some occasions, you may be going into an acoustic amp. Either way, you are going to need a pickup to amplify that sound. There's a few main variations of acoustic guitar pickups that we are going to run through. These would be the main ones that tend to be used in guitars. They started with the magnetic Soundhole pickup. These behave quite similarly to an electric guitar pickup, something like a single coil. Because you can slot these into the sound hole, they don't require any real modification of the guitar. So they were extremely popular when they were first introduced, and these are still widely used across acoustic guitarists today. The way a magnetic sound hole pickup works, to get a little sciencey on you, you have a magnet and it will be wrapped with an insulated copper wire. This will create a magnetic field. This is then disturbed by the vibrations from the strings on the guitar and then sends out an electrical current to your speaker or your amplifier. So essentially, this version of amplifying an acoustic is working off string vibrations, and you can get quite a lot of clarity from each individual string because of the way this works. However, these are known to be a little tinny if you are using these sort of pickups, as they aren't going to be picking up that body resonance that you get from the acoustic, but still a great viable option, and as I said, you don't need to modify the acoustic guitar body at all, so these are easy to use. And if you are someone that has an acoustic that doesn't come pre-fitted with a pickup, then this could be a really good option for you.
And as
I said, these do sound quite similar to the sort of sparkle you'd get from a single coil electric guitar pickup. So these will be really popular if you are after that more thin sounding acoustic guitar tone when you're playing live. It is worth noting though, these pickups won't work with any nylon strung classical guitars as they are using the steel strings to create that vibration. Hence, you'd have nothing to create that magnetic field with. So rule these out if you're looking for a pickup for your nylon strung acoustic, but if you are looking to amplify your acoustic guitar that doesn't have a pickup pre-fitted in it already, then this might be a good option for you. And this is usually probably one of the most inexpensive ways to do it. One of the most popular brands that you will see as a Soundhole pickup is the Seymour Duncan Woody. If you have seen any gigging guitarists, I'm sure you would have seen these out on the road, and these only tend to come in around £50, so a relatively easy and simple way to do it without having the cost of having to modify your guitar or cut out any sections to fit a pickup inside. On that note though, we will move on to now probably the most commonly used form of acoustic guitar pickup, the piezo pickup. This might also be known as a transducer pickup or an under the saddle pickup, but generally it will be referred to as a piezo. Piezo pickups are most commonly found under the bridge of the guitar, although there are variations where you can get it mounted onto the body, but commonly it will be mounted to the under the bridge. Piezos work by monitoring the sound pressure of your strings and converting that into an electric signal. Then that signal will be transferred onto your speaker source. To get really nerdy on you, how that would work is crystals contained inside the pickup element are compressed into a small space, and when pressure is applied either by mechanical force or by sound, the crystals are then transformed into electrical charge, which will be sent out to your speaker source. That's a very sciencey and wordy way of explaining it, but that is essentially how a piezo pickup differs and works compared to a magnetic pickup. Piezo pickups can definitely be a very bright sounding pickup and can be a little brittle to some ears. Again, leaning more on the sort of thin sounding acoustic sound, as it's not picking up the resonance again of the acoustic guitar. One thing that you do fall in love with when you buy yourself an acoustic guitar is obviously the natural resonance and overtones that the body and the woods create. You will obviously lose some of that acoustic sound and tone that you've fallen in love with. Piezos can sometimes fall a little far away from the natural sound of your acoustic guitar. They are one of the most reliable though, and tend to be used in a wide range of acoustic guitars from beginners to mid-range. Most acoustic brands that you know and love will have a piezo pickup somewhere in their range, or that'll be their entire range. These pickups may be a little brittle and thin sounding, but they would be great if you are playing in a venue that has feedback issues or tends to be quite responsive, as you have a bit more control over your sound in that sense. Also worth noting, this is a little more uncommon now, but you can get passive and active piezo pickups. Generally these days everything is going to be active, but you get the odd guitar like the Yamaha Astoria, or I have a Gretsch resonator at home which is passive. This essentially means it doesn't have an external battery source to power it. Generally this will mean that the signal is a little lower and the volume output is going to be a little lower, so you may need to get yourself a preamp with a boost on or something along those lines to shift that signal up to be loud enough to combat the live stage. But that's just worth noting. Any pickups though that do come fitted with a battery, they are active. That takes us on to the third main pickup that you get in acoustic guitars. That would be the microphone pickup. This would generally be the preferred choice for higher end acoustic brands, as you can imagine, this is going to pick up the most natural sound from the acoustic. These work by placing an internal microphone inside, positioning where you're going to pick up the most overtones and resonance from that acoustic guitar. It might be worth experimenting if you were fitting this yourself, or if you're building guitars, as each guitar does differ depending on the tone woods, the body structure and shape, and the internal bracing on how it's going to sound and resonate. So you might have to experiment on where the best place for the microphone is to go. As these are the most natural sound you'll get from a pickup, these do tend to be the most pricey option, hence why they are used by the more premium acoustic guitar brands. But you are going to get a lot more nuance out of your playing, especially if you are playing a more percussive style of acoustic guitar, or if you are doing some quite intricate and detailed finger picking. This would be a great choice for that, and it's really going to bring out the bass when you're playing percussive style, and those highs and the sparkles in your guitar tone. Guitars like the Taylor AD12 will have a microphone inside that will be helping to create that more natural sound when you plug it in. You can also nowadays get a blended option with guitars like this Yamaha over here, which have both a piezo and a microphone fitted. This would be quite good if you are playing in a range of different venues, from one night in a very loud, feedbacky prone venue and the second night in a very intimate venue, then you can switch between a piezo for that one and a microphone pickup for that one. You can also blend between the two to find the best acoustic sound for you. But that's the thing that is starting to become more common, is more experimentation with pickups across the brands. But on the whole, it generally tends to be either one of the three. I'd recommend getting into a guitar shop and trying the acoustics both acoustically and plugged in, so you get a full scope of what that guitar is going to be like to work with on the road. Whilst piezos can be quite thin, that might be the best option if you are someone that is using a lot of acoustic guitar related pedals in your setup to create an interesting tone. Likewise, if you go for a very minimalist and natural sound with your acoustic and it's all about the percussive nuance, then a microphone style pickup will probably be the best option for you. But that'll be for your ears to decide. I've given you a little demonstration in this video too of different sorts of playing and how different pickups sound, so hopefully that can help you as well. This dive into acoustic guitar pickups, a topic that may not seem the most exciting from the offset, but is definitely very interesting and a great one to dive into. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Make sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel. You can come find us on our socials at Play Music Today. I've been Meg, and I will see you all very soon.